Well, today I'd like to record a quick video about how to cut mini blinds. First thing you do, you remove the cap at the end of the bottom piece. A couple of caps there. And after that, you make sure all the blades are in line. Takes a little patience to knock them down on both sides and make sure everything is aligned. And then you have to wrap the whole thing with tape. I'm going to wrap one end, this end, with tape and compress as hard as you can. I mean, you really have to compress this. Let me do a little knocking to make sure the blades are even. Then you compress and compress and compress. So I'm going to compress and wrap. Make sure everything is even on both sides. Now I give a little pressure. I don't know if I'm still in the camera, but I'll be back there. Okay, here we go. So I have to rotate it a little bit just to wrap it up. I'm using electrical tape that's a little stretchy, but it will build up the pressure. Okay, the more pressure you have, the better. Oh, I think that's enough. Any tape will do. Okay. This thing is well compressed there. And since I'm doing this for demonstration, I did not have a line already traced. But if I find some with the pen, I'll trace it. I have to look for a pencil, hold on. Here we go. All right, I have a visible line that you can see. And basically, that's what it's all about. Everything is tight, all the blades are pressed against each other, and we have a line where we have to cut. As you know, if you try some like that before, if you use a regular blade, it will likely heat up the plastic and the blades will be stuck together. The trick is to take a wood cutting blade from a rotary saw and install it backwards. I'll show you. I have a blade here and I just flip it over. I don't know what I was cutting before, but it doesn't look too clean, but that's all right. Oh, I think I do. I was cutting a wood fence that was decaying. Pretty soft stuff that makes good kindling. You know what I mean? All right. So I have installed this blade backwards and I'm about to tighten the hole. It's all tight. Now we're going to get ready for the cut. I'm going to cut it on top of this piece of wood and I don't want to cut too deep. So I adjust my blade making sure I cut through completely. Let's check to make sure it's taller than what I'm cutting. It is. Alright. So, I think I'm about to cut this thing. And after we cut it, we'll take a look to see if things get stuck together, if things are broken, etc., etc. Alright? Cutting now. I think I saw the action, and the action showed that things were flying away, which is a good sign, meaning they were not stuck together. Now let's get this thing up and maybe give you a close up before I remove that. A close up. Okay, and remove the tape, and as you can see, all the blades are loose. Nothing is sticking, nothing is broken, just have some little plastic dust stuck at the corner. Alright, I need a closer look at that. I don't know how I can manage that, but I'll move the camera manually and show you that nothing stuck and the cut are just fine. Okay. Now the difference between this and the other side that I didn't cut yet is that all the blades were rounded up on the other side. You can see the round edge right here. They are all round. Well, you can round them up, but now you have the power to custom fit mini blinds that are too wide. If they are 2 inches too wide, 2 inches too wide, you cut 1 inch off on each hand, etc. and etc. So you remove a certain amount. Equal amount on both sides, so you can custom fit your mini blind instead of saying okay, I gotta go buy another one and throw this one out. If it's too wide, you can cut it. If it's too short, too narrow, you cannot stretch it. And that's the thought of the day. Bye bye. I thank you for watching. I am trying to do another job and I have to cut some buckets with the same principle. Here's the bucket. And to fix a special windmill. But I decided to do the mini blind piece first. Position one. Sections, not by the cut. Anything else can be removed, all that dust, you just slide a razor blade there or something, and it will all be gone. I got the shapes that I needed, and now I'm going to go on this side and try to put this corner on top of that, then do the markings and cut again, alright? And that's the job.